Lena, thank you so much for joining us today.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
So if you'd be so kind, just please talk a little bit about your career at MongoDB and your role there.
So I'm the CISO. I'm the first CISO there. I've been the first CISO at three jobs now, which is awesome because I'm not stepping into anyone else's shoes. I think CJ is doing a marvelous job of stepping into Steve Schmidt's very large, hard-to-fill shoes. So hats off to him. I've been extremely lucky in being the first CISO at the Power Authority, where I worked in critical infrastructure, then in fintech, and then now finally at MongoDB. So it's a lot of fun because you make your own rules. But you're also, you know, you're the one throat to choke, which I don't mind. That's one of the reasons I took the job. So I've been there for about 3.5 years. When I started, there was a really good security presence in place. It just wasn't under that one, you know, one umbrella, that panacea. And to be honest, I didn't walk around and say everyone with the word security in their job title now reports to me. Right. I wanted to get the lay of the land, and I'm still, you know, the land is ever shifting. And I'm still looking at the lay of the land. And I really do like the separation that we have of product security, cloud security, server security. And, you know, I talk regularly with folks who run those systems down to the engineering level, you know, up to the EVP level, just to get that feeling of where are we. And I really love that part of the job. And then I'm also responsible for governance, risk, and compliance. So that's my second team. Very distinct teams, but there's obviously a lot of collaboration. Yeah, I love it. And this is, for anyone who knows me, I'm absolutely passionate about what I do. And I've always said, the day that I wake up and say, ugh, I just don't want to do this anymore, I won't do it anymore.
Fantastic. So, you know, over the last few years, I think it's fair to say that the role of the CISO has evolved from being that sort of technical security expert to really being a business leader, right? So can you describe an opportunity that you envisioned at MongoDB? Were you able to solve a business problem through, you know, security risk, compliance, or privacy programs?
I'm always trying to see the big picture and kind of get it down into something that's, you know, someone mentioned recently eating an elephant chunk by chunk. So it's right. Kind of governance, risk, and compliance. Sometimes it's like chunk by chunk. And we basically took all of the controls that we have to comply with, of which there are over, I think, 1,200 now, and we mapped them to where we had evidence, which we have evidence for all of them.
Right.
But what we tried to do was, if one piece of evidence serves for five controls, for five different qualifications, we only have to ask the question once and then supply it five times.
Okay.
And so that's what we've been doing, and we've now saved our engineering teams probably 80% of the time they used to spend on showing me the screenshot for the antivirus,
right,
for this, you know, for, you know, for this regulatory role. And they're, you know, they have a lot of respect for what the GRC team did. And I think that's a big business benefit that engineering really appreciates, because everyone's time is valuable, but they're the folks who get the product out the door. You
right.
know, they get the patches in place, they get the security, and they maintain it. So the more time they have to do their jobs rather than giving me evidence for compliance, the better it is.
And that's spot on, right? So the less time that they're spending on sort of undifferentiated work, right, they can actually add value back to the business, which I'm sure the larger business appreciates.
I think as well, though, being with them, seeing that we're being proactive with their time,
right,
and we're being respectful of what they do as engineers. I think sometimes, and this is just my opinion, but I think sometimes in engineering is like, oh, they're just engineers, just, you know, throw them some red meat and some code and they'll be happy.
Right.
Our engineers are an amazing bunch of people, and the more time they have to collaborate and work with people like AWS, is like, that's a business profit for me.
Absolutely.
You know, they're using their time in an affordable and you know, a good manner. And we're getting so much more out of it. And my team's interested as well. My team gets to see, you know, they will now meet with the engineering person for an hour instead of a day.
Right.
And that hour is productive and it's enjoyable because they can see light at the end of the tunnel, both teams.
there's been a shift in the last few years as more companies have been adopting cloud and investing in sort of security as code and much more of an engineering effort. So security teams are going from that sort of point and click console operations to actually building code that will do things for them in the cloud at scale. Can you talk a little bit about how you view that and how you've implemented that shift at MongoDB?
So obviously we have, you know, specific tool sets, both from AWS and from other third parties. And I'm always very keen to get a real feeling of what my team has used before. So obviously we're a new team, we're a couple of years old, and getting all this new blood has been super interesting because people have used stuff that I've never heard of.
Right.
And it's like, okay, show us what it can do. And being able to share that knowledge with our security champions, with the other engineering teams, you know, the hardcore server security engineering folks who, obviously, security is always part of their systems development lifecycle, but they can now bounce real ideas and, you know, really collaborate with security engineers who this is all they've done their life and they love it and they want to just imbue this sense of we can really work together. It doesn't have to be siloed. And I think we've been really, really, really successful at breaking a lot of the silos that occur everywhere. I wouldn't say there was that many when I started at MongoDB, but I think, you know, any residual silos are gone, which I think is rare.
That's great to hear. And I guess on that sort of same track, as CISOs, we always have sort of a limited amount of security personnel that are actually in the security department working for us under our control. And what we have to do, because you can't hire a whole company full of security engineers, is sort of spread that knowledge throughout the company, make sure that you have effectively security eyes and ears throughout the business.
CISOs, we're kind of a secretive bunch at the best of times. And so my role has been to really get the word out there about security, get people excited about it, as excited as I am anyway, and just to like enjoy it and don't be scared of it. I've told my team we're not the team that says no, because sometimes you find that.
Right.
We're the team that says yes, but here's the risk,
here's fantastic.
The cost, here's the ROI, if we can give you it, you know, here's your business reason for doing it. Oh, and by the way, he's the person who's going to be responsible for it when it goes live.
Right.
So when you start bringing money, responsibility, accountability into the discussion, instead of just saying no, people are like, oh, okay, you know what? You've actually thought about this. There's thoughtfulness behind that leadership. So yeah, okay, we're with you on this. Let's work together for a solution. And I'm making it sound as though we live in this perfect world. We don't. We have people who say, well, I want to buy it just because I'm that person and I can just do what I want. And I'm like, you know what? Absolutely, you can do that. You're 100% responsible for it. And by the way, you're now on my risk register as a risk. And then they're like, oh, well, that's focused my mind a wee bit. Maybe I don't need it that much.
Well, that's spot on. The idea of security being a business partner, right? And stepping up to the plate, that absolutely will support you, but you have to understand the risks.
Yeah. I mean, there's risks with everything, but, you know, if you're introducing a new tool set that requires, and you've probably heard this, oh, I need admin access to everything. I need root. It's like, really, why? For something that does marketing
never
emails?
So switching gears a little bit to sort of security operations and security engineering a little bit, how do you ensure with your product teams at MongoDB that security is considered what I'll call early and often in the development stage, so that, you know, any security issues that pop up, you can get them in dev or test as opposed to the night before it goes into production?
Oh, yeah. I mean, security has been baked into the SDLC for MongoDB for way longer than I've been there. You know, we like to say MongoDB Atlas is secure out the box. We do everything that we can to ensure that that is true. And that goes back to having engineers who understand security, having that team mind to bounce ideas off of if they have to. There's no judgment, you know, sometimes
right.
People can be a bit judgy when it comes to code. And, you know, being able to have that open discussion of, hey, we're seeing this, should that be normal? You know, it's eye-opening to me that people go into such a level for that, you know, a deep level of uncovering possible security issues and getting them way before anybody would ever see them, you know. Not just this, you know, you're I used to handle some QA teams a few jobs ago, and it was always interesting, just the lobbing of fire grenades above, you know, QA to production, QA to production, back to dev now, oh, okay. And you've got this hellish triangle of just trying to get it out the door, whereas is here is very much because it's built into the SDLC, because it's run by engineers for engineers. There's so much fluff has just been removed from the whole process. And our CTO, of course, Mark Porter, you know, technical genius. I meet with him regularly and I can talk to him. He's got a team of experts in his office of the CTO, Octo, including an ex-CISO, which I love. And I can bounce ideas off this person and say, you know, when you were a CISO, what did you see? Because I've never had that before. Right. I've never been able to talk to, within my own company, another CISO. And so that was brilliant. I mean, I love that. I love that kind of relationship.
So what drove that level of security ownership in the development teams then? Is it just because we must build and release a secure product? But, you know, at the human factor, you know, if I'm a development engineer at MongoDB, what drives me to make sure that I'm releasing the most secure code I can?
I think basically, and this is again my opinion, it's the reputation that we have for having this security out of the box and having so many options to further secure it. You know, queryable encryption is out there now. We have a product security team that's just amazing, bar none. And they, again, staffed by engineers, for engineers, they get what they're talking about. They're developers. They come from a development background. We just hired a new VP of development productivity.
Right.
And, you know, this person's responsibility is to kind of cast a lens over all of development. You know, what are they doing? Where can they? And I hate to sound like a time and motion person because I used to work in a shipyard many years ago and we had these time and motion people who would literally walk around and measure how long it took you to drink a cup of tea. And I kind of joked with Tara when I was speaking to them last week about their job, and I said, oh, I'm not going to time me when I'm having my cup of tea. And they were like, nope, couldn't be further from that. It's basically talking at a developer level and an engineering level on how they feel they can be more productive. How can we get more product as well out the door in a more timely fashion? Because everyone wants to be out the door as quickly as possible, but remaining securely as possible. That's the important thing. And that takes time. There's always
Indeed.
That trade-off.
That's a great story. Lena, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you very much for having me.